Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 28 of our GoLang course. In this lesson, we are going to cover the if statement that we covered in the previous lesson through code. So let's begin. First we will cover the if statement, followed by the if-else statement, and then if-else if statements, and finally with variable declaration within the if statement. To start off, I will create a variable age and assign it a value of 10. So age here is an int variable of value 10. Next, I will write the if statement with a condition followed by the code block for the if statement. If age greater than equal to 18, FMT println you are an adult. So what I'm saying is, if age is greater than equal to 18, print this statement, otherwise do nothing. Since age variable has a value of 10, this particular expression will evaluate to false. What that means is, we won't see anything printed to the console. So let's run our program and verify the same. As you can see, nothing is printed to the console. Now, what if I change the value of age to 18? Now, we should expect the if code blocks to be executed, which is this particular statement. As you can see, you are an adult is printed to the console, which is what we expected since this expression is evaluated to be true. Please note that in other languages, the expression for the if statement is usually within a parenthesis or brackets. But in Go, you don't have to specify that in the parenthesis. Next, let us look at the if-else statement. To add an else block to this statement, we can do else, curly braces, then the statements that are executed when the else block is executed. FMT println, you are not an adult. Now, what I'm saying is that if this statement is true, execute the if code block, that is everything inside these curly braces, otherwise execute this code block. So, to make this condition false, I'm just going to reduce the age to 10 again, and let's see if we get the if code block to be executed. Running our program, we can see it prints you are not an adult, which is the else code block. So to revise, what's happening here is, we are saying if age is greater than equal to 18, execute this, otherwise execute this. Now let's move on to the if else if statement. The else if block will go after the if block. So I can say else if and add a new condition for it. Age greater than equal to 13, then print you are a teenager. So what I'm saying here is, if age is greater than equal to 18, print this code block. Otherwise, check if age is greater than equal to 13. If that is true, then print you are a teenager. If none of the conditions match, we don't do anything. So let's run our program to verify what happens. Since our age is 10, none of the two conditions we have specified with the if and else if statements will be evaluated to true. So nothing should happen. As you can see, nothing is printed to the console. Now, if I make age is equal to 20, the first condition will be evaluated to true and we should see this statement printed to the console. Let's run our program and see the output. As you can see, you are an adult is printed. What if I reduce the value of age to 15? So this means this condition will be evaluated to false, but this particular condition will be evaluated to true. So we should see you are teenager printed to console. Let's run our program and verify the same. As you can see, you are teenager is printed to the console. Now to handle the case where none of these two conditions are evaluated to be true, I can add a else block. Else, in the curly braces, I can add FMT println you are a child. For this code block to be executed, none of these conditions should be true. So I can make age equal to 10. Now, if I run the program, we should see this statement printed to the console. Let's run our program and see the output. And you can see you are a child is printed to the console. What happens here is, it evaluates this condition first, which doesn't match or is evaluated to false. The next condition is also evaluated to false, which leads to this code block, which is executed since none of the conditions match. You can chain as many conditions with else if blocks as possible. So I can do else if age greater than equal to 10. I can say your age is 10. And then I can add the final else block, which is FMT println your age is less than 10. Let's go by the code one line at a time. This condition specify age should be greater than equal to 18. But our age is 10, so this code block shouldn't be executed. Next, we check if age is greater than equal to 13. Since our age is 10 and not greater than equal to 13, this code block shouldn't be executed. Next, we check if age is greater than equal to 10, which our age is, So you would expect this code block to be executed. Let's run our program and verify the same. As you can see, your age is 10 is printed to the console since this condition was met and we executed this code block. So this is basically how the if statements work. You use the if keyword followed by the condition of the if and then the code blocks. Similarly, you can extend it with else if statements or the else statement. Now let's move on to our last section, which is declaring and initializing a variable inside the if statement. Here, I just created a function isEven, which takes an integer value and returns a boolean. If the integer is even, it returns true, otherwise it returns false. Now I'm going to write a if statement with a variable initialized. So in this statement, what we have done is, in the code before the semicolon, we initialized a even variable, which is the return value from the isEven function. And then after the semicolon, we evaluate the condition here. This is just a shorthand to say that if even is true, print this. You can also do even is equal to true or any condition you want here. Since age is 10, even should be true and this code blocks should be executed. I'm just going to comment the previous examples out so that we don't get any noise in the console output. Let's run our program and see what the output is. As you can see, it is working as expected. Here we initialized a even variable, then we checked if even is equal to true, and then if that condition is evaluated to be true, then we print this statement. Now, what if I make age odd? That means this statement shouldn't be executed. Let's run our program and verify the same. As you can see, nothing is executed. So that's it for our lesson. First, we covered the if statement, then the if else, followed by the chained else if statements, which you can use to evaluate multiple conditions. Lastly, we looked at variable declaration and initialization in the if statement. A thing to note here is that even, as we talked about in the lecture, is only accessible inside the if block. If you try to print even outside the if block, like fmt println even, you can see there's no variable named even. That's because it's only accessible within this code block and it's scoped to this code block only. We will cover code blocks in the next lesson, so don't worry if you don't understand what code blocks are. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. See you in the next lesson. Happy coding.